Hello and welcome to one of my other train routes. I'm now in Orange, a town in the central Tablelands region of New South Wales. Today I'm going to catch a special 1 hour and 15 minute train ride on board the legendary 3801. Orange is located 254 kilometres west of Sydney and 280 kilometres north of Canberra. The city is known for its impressive vineyards and bitterly cold winters. It is regarded as the snowiest city in Australia. Unfortunately, I missed the snow by just 3 days. Before riding on the train, for breakfast I went to Village Bakehouse on Paisley Street. Opens for 364 days a year, this family-owned cafe and bakery produces award-winning pies, cakes, pastries, freshly made paninis, wraps and burgers. When not busy, the dining environment is pretty pleasant and the portion of the dishes are quite big. If you ever found yourself in Orange, I would recommend you to pay this place a visit. And no, they didn't give me any money for me to promote them. From now on, I'd like to do what I can to support great local businesses like this one when I travel. Locomotive 3801 was manufactured in 1943 as the first of 30 38-class streamlined steam locomotives built to haul express and long-distance trains in New South Wales. The 3801 was possibly best known for the Newcastle Express services. In 1964, it operated a non-stop run from Sydney to Newcastle in a record-breaking 2 hours, 1 minute and 51 seconds. It remained the fastest journey from Sydney to Newcastle by rail until bettered by an XPT in 1988. In 1974, the Public Transport Commission barred all steam trains from operating on New South Wales mainline, hence the 3801 was withdrawn. The locomotive was then preserved by New South Wales Rail Transport Museum until 2007. During this period, the 3801 successfully operated to the capital city of every mainland state in Australia. After a 12-year overhaul from 2008 to 2020, the 3801 was relaunched on the 12th of March 2021. Today, the 3801 came to Orange to operate 5 75-minute joy rides. Tickets for these rides were sold out within weeks. It has definitely attracted a fair bit of fanfare in this town. I booked a compartment on the second ride of the day. As the train just finished the first ride and has returned to Orange, it is finally my turn. Along with the 3801 is a 42-class locomotive 4201. It is the successor of the 38-class. It is here today to haul the sleeping cars for the crew working on the 3801. Just like most other steam locomotives, the 3801's primary power source is a steam engine. The steam is generated by the boiler, and the water in the boiler is heated by burning coal. Today, locomotive 3801 is hauling 7 cars. As the ride is from point A to point B, then back to point A using the same track, the diesel locomotive at the end will be used to haul the whole train on the way back. Each of the 7 cars has different seating layout representing different travel classes during its heyday.
37?
37
or whatever, it's up.
Up there, this way?
This way.
Thank you.
The carriage that we'll be travelling on is MBE62. This is a wooden body first class carriage typically seen on express or long distance service with a seating capacity of around 45 passengers. The guard of my carriage, Graham, was really nice and he allowed me to get on board early to film the carriage without having anyone on board. Welcome to my first class compartment. The compartment consists of 6 leather seats. Does it remind you of the Hogwarts Express in Harry Potter? The seats are fitted with thick cushions which made them super comfortable to sit in. Each seat is clearly divided by an armrest and a headrest. The carriage is not air-conditioned, but there's a fan above the door. You can see that the seat numbers are easily changeable, so are the reserved signs. On services that the seats are not reserved, I reckon they can just put not above the sign reserved. The compartment is decorated with pictures showcasing Australian landscapes, and above each seat there's a luggage rack. I tried to turn on the fan and the lights, but seems like this carriage is not powered today. Each compartment features 2 large windows, and you can actually see the scenery from both sides of the train. For added privacy, each compartment has a slide door, which is also lockable. At one end of the carriage, there's a ladies' bathroom. It is very spacious. So this is my first class carriage on long distance or express trains. Let's have a look at the seating arrangement in other carriages. Car C is a N-type carriage, entered service in early 1940s. This car was originally a combined first and second class carriage on short distance trains, but was later converted to half buffet, half second class carriage. The second class seats on short distance or stations trains are in open saloon in a 2-2 configuration. The first class seats on N-type carriages should be in a 2-1 configuration, but I didn't find any first class seats on the train today. Be aware that the carriage layout may not be the same as what it was 50 to 70 years ago. I think they have most likely been modified.
Hello. So is this the 2-people seat or is it 4-people?
Yeah, so we've kind of got a split carriage where we have these 4 kind of suburban inner city seats.
Yes.
And then if you go a little bit further, this is the kind of long green seats.
These
are the seats for 2. Usually we used to be able to turn these around and there were 2-seaters.
Yeah.
But we can't turn around anymore.
Oh, okay.
So they're all 4-seaters.
Okay. Thank you.
Car B used to be a composite carriage with half first class and half second class seats. Today, half the carriage is fitted with seats on intercity or suburban trains, and the other half is the second class seating. You can see the bathroom on short distance trains are much smaller in size. Now back to my first class compartment, and the ride is about to begin. I'm surprised that the windows can be opened.
Lucky them.
Yes, the train leaves at 10:15, so I should show up at 10:14 and 59 seconds.
While us on the train are waiting for the remaining passengers to board, one of the staff is giving those at the end of the platform a safety briefing. The engine can be really loud.
It's very noisy, and if you don't like noise, don't be here. I can't, no, I mean it. I can't, if somebody panics, I can't help you.
Newcastle. I've been away for a week and staying in that trailer.
That's proper.
The route for the joyride is fairly simple. We will travel on the main western line towards Sydney, passing Huntley, Springfield, Millthorpe, and we will stop at Ponola Loop to wait for the Outback Explorer service to go past us, then the train will head back to Orange following the same way. The smoke from the engine can actually come through the windows. There are ashes dropping on my pants. In winter, it's freezing when the windows are open. Here we are at Ponola Loop, approximately 30 kilometers south of Orange. I also figured that there are blinds for the windows. Marks the end of the first half of the trip. Now let's head back to Orange. Being able to pop my head out of the window reminds me of my trip to India. Well, do it at your own risk though. On the way back, I walked through different carriages again to discover the rest of the train. This is car C that I showed you earlier, fitted with short distance second class seats. I can't believe how many people on this train actually know who I am. That's incredible.
It's YouTube star.
Oh, do you guys know?
Our friend Thomas, who got a photo with you, tell us all about you. Nice
to meet you.
This is car F, a refurbished first class carriage. The people in this compartment were so nice and allowed me to have a look inside. The seats look brand new. I reckon this carriage was refurbished in recent years. There's no way it can be this new after decades of service.
When do you reckon you'll post this video?
I try Thursday.
If not.
Finally, we are in car E. Can you see the compartment in this carriage have 8 seats instead of 6? Before catching this train, all I knew was that there were first class and second class seats on board. Therefore, I thought my compartment was first class and the green seating open saloon was second class. So I got really confused on why these compartments are labeled as second class as well. The guard in this carriage wasn't really helpful.
So there are 4 reserved seats on each side in this carriage. And then the first class is like 3 on the side. Is it
the difference? I'm not sure.
Thankfully, Graham, the guard in my carriage, was really patient and knowledgeable. He was able to clear my questions in my head.
But in its heyday, yes, you booked a seat either first class or second class. And as I just explained to the young lady there, that depending upon as to where the train was going, whether it was an express train or whether it was just simply an all-station stop type train, where the red seats are, that was classed as first class. The next petition was classed as second class, but it's a tourist car. It's not an express, as I said, it would be going between point A and point B and would be stopping at every stop.
So first class, second class is different on different trains?
Different trains, yep. Different types, yeah. Well, that green one, that's a 42 class locomotive, that would have been very close to one of the first locomotives, diesel locomotives that they produced.
That repays.
So again, it and the 38 are sort of synonymous, right? I've replaced you.
Now they've both been replaced.
Yeah, they're both replaced.
So this is my experience on the 75-minute ride on board the 3801. The ride was fun and the carriages were preserved really well. One thing that I think they need to improve on though is the staff. I talked to a total of 6 staff. 3 of them were very happy to answer my questions, especially Graham. The other 3 seem to be annoyed when I ask some questions. I'm not sure whether they are employed by Transport Heritage New South Wales or are volunteers, but either way, they should know that for rides like this, there will be lots of people who like to ask heaps of questions. I don't know how many more decades this train can be kept running safely, but the knowledge needs to be transferred to the younger generations. I think answering questions is a really good way of transferring such knowledge. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you find it interesting, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. I have made a number of train reviews across Australia, such as the Indian Pacific, Spirit of Queensland and New South Wales XPT. There will be a lot more coming your way as well. So please subscribe to my channel for more train, flight and hotel reviews. See you all in my next video.